Hello everyone, welcome to a new session. In today's lesson, we'll look at a story entitled An Exciting Trip. 大家好，今天我们要学习的课文是关于一个令人激动的旅行。Well, the story is about a man who plans to take a trip to some places in Australia. 故事呢，讲的是有一个人准备在澳大利亚的几个地方去旅行。Alright, now let's start with keywords and expressions. Exciting. Receive a letter. Firm. A great number of. Different. Alice Springs. Darwin. Perth. 以上三个都是澳大利亚的地名。Abroad. Okay, next I'm going to give you three questions on the text. Please keep them in mind while you watch and listen to the story. 下面我就课文提三个问题，大家在听的时候请注意这些问题的答案。How long has Tim been in Australia? Tim 在澳大利亚待了有多长时间了？ What does he do in Australia? 他在澳大利亚做什么工作？ Why is Tim finding the trip exciting? Tim 为什么对这次旅行感到很激动？
I have just received a letter from my brother, Tim. He is in Australia. He has been there for 6 months.Tim is an engineer. He is working for a big firm, and he has already visited a great number of different places in Australia. He has just bought an Australian car and has gone to Alice Springs, a small town in the centre of Australia. He will soon visit Darwin. From there,He will fly to Perth. My brother has never been abroad before, so he is finding this trip very exciting.
Right. How much did you understand the story? 刚才的故事大家听懂了多少呢？ Well, let's see if you can answer those questions. 下面呢，我们来看看问题，看看大家能不能回答。How long has Tim been in Australia? Tim 在澳大利亚待了有多久？ Tim has been in Australia for 6 months. Tim 在澳大利亚待了已经有六个月了。What does he do in Australia? 他在澳大利亚干什么？ He is working for a big firm as an engineer.他呢是个工程师，在为一家大公司工作。Why is Tim finding the trip exciting? Tim 为什么对这次旅行感到非常激动？ Because Tim has never been abroad before, so he is finding the trip very exciting. 因为 Tim 以前从来没有出过国，所以呢这次旅行让他感到很激动。Okay, now let's move on to language points. 下面呢，我们就来看看课文中的语言点。He is working for a big firm. 他在为一家大公司工作。Firm 意思是公司。在英文中，公司还可以说 company。但是如果说法律公司，我们一般都说 law firm.He has already visited a great number of different places in Australia. 他已经去过澳大利亚的不少地方了。句中的 a great number of 是一个固定词组，意思是许多。它后面要跟可数名词。这里呢，也可以用另外一个词组来替代 a great many different places. 比如说，许多人也可以说 a great many people。a great many 后面也是跟可数名词。那么不可数名词，比如说钱，许多钱、大量钱，就要用 a great amount of。a great amount of money。My brother has never been abroad before, so he is finding this trip very exciting. 我兄弟以前从来没有出过国，所以呢，这次旅行让他感到非常激动。去过什么地方，要说 have been to some place。比如，Have you ever been to Hong Kong？你去过香港吗？Have you ever been there？你去过那里吗？下面我们再看两个例子。He has been to the south。他去过南方。He has gone to the south。他现在去了南方。那么这两个句子中呢，我们主要是区分一下 have been to some place 和 have gone to some place。前者说的是他去过什么地方，现在可能已经回来了，而这一句呢，表示说他现在已经去了，还没有回来。Abroad 是副词，它和动词组合在一起，可以组成不同的词组，比如 go abroad 出国，travel abroad 到国外旅行。Study abroad，到国外留学；live abroad，居住在国外。在这个句子中，还有一个表达式非常有用，那就是 find 加上名词，再加上形容词。它的意思呢是说，觉得什么怎么样。下面我们来看看例句：I find this book very interesting。我觉得这本书非常有趣。Did you find the film disappointing？你有没有觉得这部电影很让人失望？Trip 是名词，意思是旅行。到什么地方去旅行？英文中可以说 take a trip to some place。请看这个例句。I'm planning to take a trip to Tibet next month. 下个月我打算去西藏旅行。Take a trip to Tibet. Okay, now we are going to look at key structures and usage. 下面呢，我们就来看看本课的关键句型。在这一课中出现了现在完成时态。那么下面我们一起来看看课文中的几个句子。I have just received a letter from my brother Tim。我刚刚收到我弟弟 Tim 的来信。He has been there for 6 months。他在那儿已经待了6个月了。He has just bought an Australian car and has gone to Alice Springs。他刚刚买了一辆澳大利亚的小汽车，现在呢去了小镇 Alice Springs。现在完成时是由助动词 have 或者 has 加上过去分词构成的。在这三个句子中，现在完成时分别为 have received、has been、has bought、has gone。助动词是用 have 还是 has，要根据主语是什么样的人称和数来决定。比如第一人称单数和复数呢，都要用 have。在这里是 I have received。如果是第三人称单数呢，助动词就要用 has。比如这里的主语是 he，所以要用 he has been。下面我们看看 和现在完成时经常连用的表示时间的副词，请大家注意例句中的例体字。I have just arrived by train. 我刚刚坐火车到。He has already left. 他已经走了。I haven't heard from him since then.
从那以后，我没有得到过他的音讯。
The train has not arrived yet.
火车还没有到。
The weather has been good so far.
到现在为止，天气还不错。
今天的课文话题呢，是关于旅行。说起旅行，我想很多人都会同意这样的看法。旅行呢，可以开阔人的眼界，可以使人见世面。Travel broadens one's mind. 那么出国旅行呢，更是如此。When you travel abroad,You can visit new places, meet new people, try different food, and experience new cultures.
你出国旅行呢，就可以参观不同的地方，可以品尝不同的风味食品，另外呢，可以见到新的人，最重要的是你可以体验到不同的文化。
Well, if you had a chance to go abroad, which country would you prefer to visit?
假如你有机会出国的话，你会选择去哪个国家旅行呢？
Okay, that's it for today's session. Until next time, goodbye.